WDSU First Warning Weather, you see it's an impact day. This is going to come in two parts. The first part this evening, tonight, into the early part of the over hours is for the chance and threat for severe storms. Then we turn the threat for flooding, and this goes through the overnight through the morning hours. So two parts to it, and it's the flood risk. That's the one that's the most concerning and could affect the most. WDSU First Warning Weather Doppler Radar is where we start. We've got those showers all around that are pretty much light right now, the steady, maybe pockets of moderate showers, I would say, in and around the city. A pocket of a heavier downpour will be on its way northeast, but we've got West Bank steady moderate rain there that's going to be on the expressway, and we also have Gentilly into Lakefront, also some showers, pockets of heavier rain, Violet, Poydras, heavy rain, Franklinton, as you go to the border with Tangipahoa Parish and Mississippi border, and really light rain now in Tangipahoa to Independence to Ponchatoula. The Kill's got some steady rain instead of Space Center. We've got the showers that'll be in the Slidell before you know it. Heavy rain and moved out of the river parishes. Right now, just maybe some shower activity. Pockets of heavier downpours will be popping up here and there. So everybody's got this batch of light rain right now, but you look west. This is the round of possible severe weather that could be here later on tonight. I expect more storms to pop up really ahead of that system. Everybody in the yellow, those are tornado watches right now. Don't expect that here, as we're going to have a little bit different of a situational setup, and I'll show you in a minute. Real-time temperatures after the highs today, we hit mid-80s. We're still into the 70s. The humidity is still really high for the time of the year, into the 70s. This is usually late summer humidity. Had wind gusts to 30 earlier. The breeze not as strong either. So there's some good news, as maybe the atmosphere is relaxing a bit from some data I'd seen a little bit earlier. Cold front extends down with that system that's brought the tornado watches and the high humidity, but the humidity plume is what I want to show. This is the atmospheric humidity from ground all the way up into the air. Do you see that we're on the nose of that humidity plume that extends farther south? This is all from the leftovers of what was Sarah. So the front's coming through, tapping into all that humidity and the chance for that severe weather and flooding. And then, other part of that forecast, you ready for that colder air? Our first real chill of the season and some possible frosts will be on the way. So there's a look at Doppler radar once again, and into the short-term forecast lines up pretty well. Shower activity on and off, but as we get to midnight to 2, this could be the stronger storm activity, and that's going to be that severe risk. So I'd say around 10 p.m. to 2 a.m., we're looking at a low-level threat. Home zone, they're a level 2. There is a risk for some isolated weak tornadoes, but those storms will start to move together and last through tomorrow morning, where there could be bouts of very heavy rain with several inches possible. Got widespread possible 2 to 3 inches or more on that southwest northeast line, and that's right in line with that flood watch that is in effect now and goes until noon on Tuesday. So to sum it up, the severe weather happens first, then the flood risk will happen second overnight. That threat for the severe weather is about that 10 p.m. to 2 a.m. window, and then that threat for flooding all the way until the rain ends Tuesday morning. Temperatures tomorrow, not too bad, 70s, but it's going to be raining or wet roads, so give yourself extra time. Check it with Brady B. Harris, meteorologist Raven Richard. We do have flood advisories kicking in once again, and of course, small craft advisories too. But things are getting better. Tomorrow afternoon, it's not colder just yet. We're still at about 80 degrees. It won't be until the winds kick in going in here into Wednesday. This is where those temperatures start to go down. We're looking at 70s for top temperatures, and even cooler as we get into Thursday into Friday. Those highs are down into the 60s with a strong west wind, northwest wind. We could be our first frosts of the season. See North Shore lows 37, 38. Bogalusa might be down as cool as 35.